Now see here, what is the neutral surface and a neutral axis? So for that diagram is shown here. You can see the neutral axis here and these are layers here. So this is a bending beam. So what happens it is when it is bent? So for that consider the beam that one end is fixed here and another end is free to apply the load. So what happens is the beam which consists of the number of parallel layers here. So this is one layer, this is another layer. So each layer consists of number of filaments. So when say the load is attached to the free end, the beam bends here. So this is the bending diagram here shown. So this is AB is shown as here A dash B dash and it is CD. Next EF is shown as E dash F dash. So next here the successive layers along with the constituent filaments are strained here. The filament AB of an upper layer. So this is AB. That upper layer will be elongated. That it is represented as here A dash B dash. Similarly the lower layer that is EF that will be contracted as E dash F dash. And there will be a particular layer. There the filaments they do not undergo any change in their length, that it is represented as here CD. So such layers are called as neutral surface or it is also called as neutral plane. And the line along which the filament it is situated, that it is called as neutral axis. So now see, the neutral surface or plane is that layer of a uniform beam which do not undergo any change in its dimension when the beam is subjected to bending. So that is within the elastic limit here. So next see what is neutral axis, that definition it is given here. So it is the longitudinal line along which neutral surface is intercepted by longitudinal plane, that is considered in the plane of bending. So when the uniform beam is bent, all its layers which are above the neutral surface are elongated here, means they are undergoing elongation, and below the neutral surface are subjected to the compression. Means see, you can see here in the diagram. So these all upper layers, that is this is neutral surface, upper layers are undergoing elongation, lower surface are undergoing contraction. So next the two forces which are acting that results in restoring couple, they are balancing the applied couple acting on the beam. So the moment of restoring couple is called as here restoring moment, and the moment of applied couple, that is subjected to which the beam undergoes bending longitudinally, which is called as bending moment. So when the beam is in equilibrium, the beam the bending moment and restoring moments are equal. So this is the diagram here. So this is the beam it is shown. So the forces of reaction are shown here and the forces of reaction, that is how it is in the direction you can see. So this is your neutral axis. So these are all about neutral axis and neutral plane.